So we're now joined by Kari Rosbeck. Kari, thank you for joining me again. We're in June now, and we're coming off such an incredible month of May. May is TSC Awareness Month, and it was such a busy month for the organization. We recognized TSC Global Awareness Day, and we also held our second global virtual walk, run, ride. Can you share some highlights from that weekend?
Oh my goodness. How about the whole week? Because we did these amazing lunch and learns the whole week leading up to that walk weekend and highlighted some of the journeys of families and individuals living with TSC. And of course, on Sunday, the last day of the walk, we had all of our amazing future leaders join us. So I just say that process meant so much. Also, we had literally 2,102 people participate, 200 teams. The engagement by the community was really magical. And as a result, we had set a goal of raising $700,000. And as of today, we have raised $795,900. Last year, when we first did this, we raised $660,000. So you can see really the amazing results of an engaged community and doing this all together.
So we also used that weekend to announce a pretty big change for the organization. So for those of you who don't know, we've changed our name. We're now the TSC Alliance, as you can tell from our backgrounds, and I'm wearing my TSC Alliance shirt. So I guess first, what prompted the need for the name change and this new branding?
We're coming into this new era of really being a leader in the rare disease space. And so the look and feel was really to highlight the progress that we've made, but also where we are heading. And I know Steve and I go out and give a lot of presentations, and we're already introduced as the TSC Alliance because that's the name of the disease, that's the name of the genes. It was a natural evolution, not a revolution. And we certainly included the community every step of the way. And the result is just amazing. I love this logo so much. And I remember Heather Linz in particular saying this logo felt like the organization was hugging her and her family. And that's the kind of hopeful, forward-thinking, relentless, smart organizational feel that we wanted.
This month, on Friday, June 18th, you're celebrating a pretty big anniversary with the TSC Alliance. It's your 20th anniversary. First of all, just thank you for leading this organization, creating a culture where we've been able to move things forward, and everyone on our team has such a important role in our overall mission. How has the organization changed in the time that you've been there?
When I met in living rooms and hospital conference rooms and church basements with people 20 years ago, we were trying to educate about the manifestations. There were different treatment options, say for epilepsy, but not that was systemic or disease modifying. It was a very different dynamic holding people's hands and letting them know that we would be there to today. Taking an active role in research as an organization, actually driving and funding research, and providing true hope that we are going to change the course of TSC over the next two decades.
What has it meant to you to just be part of this incredible organization for the last 2 decades? And, what's your vision for the next 5 and 10 years?
It's meant everything. It's become my life's mission. I want us to get to a point where people can live with TSC as a chronic disease, meaning in the next 5 to 10 years, I would like every baby born to be tested for TSC. I would like then to have a preventative treatment. So then babies can be treated for epilepsy before the onset of first seizures and change the trajectory of their life. I'd love for us to find biomarkers to be able to prevent kidney tumors from growing or from LAM from progressing. And I really feel like we're on the cusp of that in the next 5 to 10 years. Thank you all so much. We are a successful organization because of every single one of you. We wouldn't be where we are today without you, without your knowledge, without your courage in sharing your stories, and without the ability to be inspired by you. I every day am so grateful for every single member of our community.